So, tons of context is needed. Homebrewing, not that kind of homebrewing, is when you add unauthorized applications to the device. The one that you've probably heard about is the Nintendo 3DS homebrewing scene, since eShop shut down a while ago. But there are others like the Wii, Nintendo Switch, PS4, PS3, PS2, PS1. Basically, if the device you have can do things, then it probably has a homebrew. And homebrew allows for a lot of cool things like game ports, piracy, and tweaks to the console itself. The Vision Pro is Apple's latest device that blends AR and VR in a sleek form factor. So what would happen if we were to put Vision Pro and homebrew together? Hopefully not a big explosion like this one, because today I'm going to be trying it out. It's pretty well known that Apple devices are a lot more locked down than Android phones. Androids have APKs, themes, and a different operating system, while iPhones don't have any of that. That's why you'd think it'd be pretty difficult to get unauthorized apps on the Vision Pro, right? Right? $16 a year. That's a small price you need to pay to get MapleSign, a way to add unauthorized iOS apps to the Vision Pro. Not sponsored, obviously. Once everything is set up, there you go. We've got access to all these ad-ridden and buggy apps. Hey, I never said these apps would be good. Now, the apps that I really want to discuss in this video are the ones that do emulation. So, help me welcome to the stage, RetroArch, one of, if not the best way to emulate the most popular consoles like the DS, N64, GameCube, PlayStation, etc, etc. Starting with a simpler console like the DS, both the games that I've tried work perfectly on here. My favorite experience was Pokemon Platinum, mainly because this game was my childhood, so playing it on such a big screen is incredible. Then there's the Nintendo 64, which, again, is perfect. And Super Mario 64 ran really well with no hiccups. Leave a like if you grew up with the DS version of this game, and ending things with a much more graphically intensive console, the original PlayStation, which runs... yeah, why am I even surprised? Runs at a smooth 60fps, and I can definitely see myself playing a game like Spyro on here. And before you spam the comments section, here's Doom running on the Vision Pro. There, happy now? In my testing, I wasn't able to get Dolphin, the Wii and GameCube emulator, nor Play, the PS2 emulator, to work since they require a compilation method called JIP, which I doubt would work since you can't connect the Vision Pro to a computer, but let me know if there's a way to get it working in the comments. And it's such a shame since it also means that Dreamcast games don't work, and the Switch emulator just refuses to run any game that you give it. But there you go, that's homebrew and emulation on the Apple Vision Pro. Of course, a $3,500 headset is overkill for playing a game like Super Mario Bros. It's a shame that the cooler consoles like the Wii and GameCube don't work. However, it's still fun to try out. It's awesome playing these childhood games of mine on such a big screen and in these beautiful environments. I'm sure as time passes, there will be many ways to play these consoles on the Vision Pro, and I personally can't wait. That's the best part of the homebrew scene. There's so many great developers that create apps done impossible every single day. This video was actually inspired by John Moore's video about the different ways to play retro games on the Vision Pro, so go check that one out in the description. Make sure to subscribe to see more content like this one. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and take care!